Sorry, I'm going back to Dragon Essence. Come on, last time we left off. We're getting married to Mengji. Oh my goodness. And I don't want to. I just want to marry Tian Zhao and be happy. I don't care about anybody else. Qian. I can hear Mengji's voice from afar. As I draw closer to him, with each step, I reminisce the past. The past I'm about to let go. What? No! No, don't let go of him. Hold on to him, trust me. Suddenly I stop. Good. I can't continue to move forward. That's right! Be with your man! Don't be with him! Don't be with Mengji! Qian? What's wrong? I just can't. Qian? Stop! Qian! Oh, sorry. Wrong voice. Qian! Like a sudden blinding light that sneaks under the veil. He holds me from falling into the depth of the abyss. Stop this wedding. Continue. Episode 7. Essence! The name is in the title! Several hours ago, okay. What happened 7 hours ago? Huh? Zhao? That is strange. He was here just a moment ago. Where could he be? Finally, I could get in. It's getting hard to sneak into the storage room lately. Alright, now that I'm here. If my hunch is correct, there has to be something here. Something I overlooked. There are many things that you do not know, Zhao. Well, it's not like I'm into rumors and stuff. This is not about others. This is about your own family. Even family can have secrets they don't want to talk about. Sometimes I wish you could care a little more. It's not that I don't care, sis. You thought I didn't know, but it's obvious that you guys are hiding something from me. I thought I shouldn't ask if you guys didn't want me to know. But the situation has changed. I need to know too. Whew. This restaurant is really good.
That's what he was looking for?
I didn't know Grams keeps such high quality wines here. What am I doing? I should be looking for information 15 years ago, not wines from ages ago. Concentrate. I need to concentrate. He got distracted again, didn't he? I feel like I've been here forever, since forever. There are nothing but medicines, tea, wine, books, and plenty of useless scrolls. Is there really nothing of importance here? No, it can't be. That doesn't explain Grimes' attitude. He always gets really mad whenever I sneak in without his permission. There has to be something. Huh? The scroll is reacting. Did Qian write something on it? Let's see. What? Qian! This ain't the time to be here. I need to go back to Qian. Ouch! What's a bump doing here? Huh? What's this? I never seen it before. It's locked. None of the stuff here is locked. Why is this the only one? Could it be? Doesn't even budge. What a powerful lock. They really don't want anyone to see what's inside, huh? Too bad you're dealing with me. Gotcha. Let's see what's inside. Oh, the dagger. Zhao, where were you? I was looking for you just now. Sis, I'm going back to the human's realm. I know Gramps won't allow it, even if I ask, so please tell him I'm leaving. Wait a second. Zhao? Sorry, sis.
Qian needs me.
I must go. Hold it right there. Did you think you can leave without your grandpa's permission? I shall use force if I must. A water barrier, huh? Sis, if you want to stop me, you gotta try harder than that. Chion, wait for me. Stop this wedding. What's going on?
Isn't that the Dragon Lord?
What is he doing here? Tian Zhao. Tian Zhao. Tian Zhao. I throw my veil off as I rush into his arms. Come on. Let's get out of here. Yes. Take me. Take me with you. Yes. I hold his hand as we make our way out of the hall. But no. Qian. Mingji, what are you doing standing there? Go get her. No. You know it, Xiaoyan. How hard I've tried all this time. She's always been so close. That is why I naively thought I could easily reach her. But just like this guy, no matter how far I stretched my hands, she was never within my reach. Mingji, Lo Zhu, they've escaped again. Should we make chase? No, I've already had a feeling this would happen. Still seeing their fortune is something else. It's unfortunate she has left us with no choice. Then, Mao Cao, Kong Yun. Yes, you know what to do. Yes, my lord. So this is the path we have chosen. Don't regret it, Qian. Oh, I'm nervous. Stop. I don't think I can go on. Are you okay? Want me to carry you? Don't tease me.
Yes, carry me.
You know, you look really beautiful in that dress. Huh? I can't stop my face from turning red. Why did you come? I didn't tell you to come, did I?
Are you sure about that?
Are you sure you ain't dying for me to come and take you away? Is it that obvious? It's written all over your face. Reflexively, I covered my face in embarrassment. I know you didn't say that, but you wouldn't have told me everything if you didn't really want me to come. How could I ever bear to leave you alone after knowing all that? To be honest, I didn't know whether I want you to come or not. I didn't realize it until the last moment, how much I wanted to see you again. Qian. But is this really okay? If you go with me, then what's going to happen to your mother? No, mother. We have to save her. Let's go find the dragon priest. I'll talk to him. Do you think he'll listen? I'll make him, even if he doesn't want to. Let's go. Oh, I got a bad feeling. This way to the dragon temple. Alright. You're losing breath. Are you sure you're okay? I'm fine. We must hurry. Yeah. Tian Zhao? Huh? I tried to remain strong, but my trembling hands gave it away. Mother, she's going to be fine, right? Oh God, I'm nervous. Here we are. As I try to catch my breath, a familiar scene greets us. The abnormal presence of a large crowd of people, and the singing feeling that something terrible had happened. This is exactly like the day when I returned from the dragon's room. Tian Zhao?
Stay close to me.
Yeah. Look, that's her! The heretic! How terrible! The amassing whispers are loud enough for me to hear. Together with her piercing gaze, it's enough to make my stomach turn. Just being here is excruciating. If I could, I would run away as far as I can. But I must bear it all, for this is the result of our action. I keep telling myself that, as I brace for what's to come. They killed Mom! No. This can't be happening. Mother?
What? That's your mother?
As though my entire world had just collapsed, I lost I lose my balance and fall.
Qian.
Qian's out tries to hold me, but my legs can no longer support the rest of my body.
Why?
Why is this happening?
Why? You know that better than anyone. You have made your choice, therefore she has to pay for it.
It's as simple as that. Without giving me any chance to think, the priest appears before me once again.
Give back. Give me back. Give me back my mother.
My crying voice turns into a hysterical shriek. Every once in my life, the presence of someone can make me arbor them with every fiber of my being.
Give you back.
The strong cynic, the man mocks me using my words.
Don't make me laugh.
If there is anyone to blame, then there can only be one.
It's you.
What? It's you who are abandoning your mother.
No.
It's you who let yourself be blinded by your own ego.
That's not...
We have given you a chance and you chose to throw it away.
That's right.
You brought this upon yourself.
No.
Lost. I've completely lost myself. I thought I was prepared for anything. I thought I was strong enough to face the consequences of my action. But I was wrong. Very wrong.
It's my fault.
Qian.
It's all my fault.
Qian. He really calls my name. I can no longer hear him. Something in me is breaking apart.
Qian.
All of a sudden, without a warning, a blinding light envelops us. It takes my conscience away with it as everything comes to a rough end.
I'm sad now. Give me a few minutes. I'm back. I'm a little bit better. Oh, Qian, you're back.
Mother, I prepared breakfast for you. It's your fairy mantle.
Come here and eat.
I'm sorry.
But I'm glad you look so happy.
I haven't seen you this happy in a while.
I'm really sorry.
It's all my fault.
Everything is my fault. Qian.
My consciousness keeps drifting in and out. As I sink deeper into a pool of darkness.
Qian.
There's nothing. Only never-ending emptiness.
Qian. Huh? A light?
Someone is calling me.
Finally.
My voice finally reaches you. You must be wondering what just happened. I used my powers to create a bright light. Those who were exposed to it would be paralyzed for a moment. I used the chance to get us out of that place. It was quite taxing, and I'm totally worn out thanks to it, but still. Dragons are pretty amazing, huh? And that's not the only thing we can do. Say, Qian, if you had to choose between your mother and I, who would you choose?
Sorry.
Don't answer it. It's a horrible question. Don't worry. I won't put you through that.
Qian...
Zhao?
Wait! Where are you going? Qian Zhao!
Sis, if you want to stop me, you gotta try harder than that. For you to be able to dissolve my barrier that easily.
What power?
I have been watching you all this time. Without me knowing, you've grown so much. I know I'm a kid. I always do things without thinking. But children will stay young forever. We have to grow up eventually, make our own decisions, and walk our own paths. Whether it's right or wrong, good or bad, you can only live on to witness it.
Sal,
that's why, sis. Please tell Gramps that whatever choice his children have made, it wasn't his fault. Regardless, it's Auntie's Yang or me.
Don't tell me you, dragon essence.
That's the true reason why we're viewed as gods.
So you knew.
What? this is. You are a remnant of the past from being once known as Yon Yang. I knew it. Maybe it's because we're both white dragons. You too? That's right. I'm Tian Zhao, the white dragon of the seventh generation. I came here in search for the truth. 15 years ago, why did you choose to take your own life? Was it really just to follow your spouse? How about your child? Are you gonna abandon him just like that? Or is it just maybe? He has already died back then. When I heard about what happened 15 years ago, I thought that something ain't right. The baby was abnormally quiet during the entire ordeal. So I thought, just like your spouse, he might have already died. Am I right? That's correct. A blood is special. They carry the very essence of the dragons. In exchange for a dragon's life, you can be blessed with a long life cured from any illness, injuries, and even deaths.
Oh my god, please don't tell me, Tian, I was gonna sacrifice myself to bring back my mom.
It's a true miracle that only dragons can do. I see. Now everything makes sense. You took your life in order to save him. Do you think it was futile?
Huh?
I wanted to leave the fruit of our love in this world. A proof that humans and dragons can live together side by side. I don't regret my decision. Even so, I can't help but wonder if everything I've done is futile. No. If I were you, I would do the same thing. Thanks, Auntie Annie. Thanks to you, I've decided. That's why. You can rest in peace. To be honest, I was relieved when I heard the truth. Auntie Yang, she didn't abandon her child. She did it to bring hope for the future generation. That perhaps someday dragons and humans can live together side by side. That's why I intend to continue what she sought to do. Maybe just Qian and I alone will be enough. Maybe what we're doing is futile. But I want to believe that it's not impossible. So, I must go now. Qian is waiting for me. And this time, I'm not gonna let him go. I'll be missing to the very end. You don't mean... Sorry, sis. I do really love you all. Take care of Grimms for me. Farewell. Qian Zhao? You call?
Oh, thank goodness he's still alive.
Qian Zhao! Embracing the moment I see him. What's wrong? You look like you're gonna die. I had a nightmare. A nightmare that you're going away. I'll hold him tightly in fear that he might disappear any second. In response, he gently caresses my head and smiles. It's just a dream. I'm not going anywhere. I see. It's just a dream. It's just a dream. It's just a dream. I read my own words and attempt to reassure myself. Huh? What about my mother? She's right behind you. What? I turn around and see my mother lying on the grass. Don't worry, she's just sleeping. She'll be awake in no time. Really? So it was all just a dream? My mother didn't die. You're not going away. Everything turns out fine. Right? He doesn't answer. I'm a little tired. Can I borrow your shoulder? Huh? Okay. I nod in embarrassment. It's late. Yeah, it's the same one we passed by the other day. I thought it was a good place to rest. I see. It was just yesterday since we last were here, but it felt like it's been forever. So many things has happened since then. What's gonna happen to us from now on? He doesn't answer it yet again. Ain't the setting sun beautiful? Oh my god, don't tell me he's gonna die. It's like the deep blue sky melts together with the golden sun. They're already beautiful on their own, but they're even more beautiful together. A pity that it doesn't last long. Oh, right. You can't see colors. Hey, Qian. Would you be happier if you're able to see colors? Huh? You said that you're attracted to me because I'm the only color you can see in this world. If you can see colors, then wouldn't you be fine even without me? What? Two men and ducks playing in the water. When one dies, the other would soon follow. It just couldn't live on its own. But Qian, You have your mother. You have your friends. You're not alone. You don't really need me to continue living. Why? Why are you saying this? It's not like you're going away. That's right. My mother's alive. We are finally together. Everything's supposed to be over. And why is it so unsettling? Why does my chest hurt so much? Huh? Only then I realize something warm on my palm. I raise my hand to see what it is. What is this blood? Tian Zhao? What did he do? A life for a life. It's only fair, ain't it? This way, you and your mother can keep on living. No, that can't be. Anything that happened just now, it wasn't a dream. Oh, my heart. Why? Why would you do that? You never actually did do that. Why do you always decide everything on your own? Why? Sorry, I can't think of anything else. Knowing that you will have to carry the guilt of losing your mother because of me, I just can't. Nerves is right. It's always the older one who is wise. And us, the children, who just won't listen. But she on. I don't regret it. It may have been short and foolish life I'm living. But from the start to the end, I've always been true to myself. Tian Zhao. I'm really tired. Let me sleep. Yeah. For the time in my world, when there's no such thing as colors. I couldn't imagine a world of color would look like. At least not until that day. And then what? That's anymore. And that's the end. That's so sad. They died. I'm pretty sure only one died. So they didn't get together in the end. That's so sad. It's just a story. You don't have to cry so hard. Listen, I'm crying really hard right now. I'm not crying. You're crying. Yes. Why don't cry, baby? Hey guys, where's your manner? We haven't seen the storyteller yet. Oh, you're right. Thank you so very much for telling us the story. It's my pleasure. Thank you for listening. It's a beautiful story, but I'm not satisfied. The girl who was left behind, I wonder what happened to her. Are you curious? Not long after that, the dragons came and explained what happened. Dragon essence? That's how it was. You do not seem to be surprised. Did you already know? I saw a vision when I was unconscious. A vision of Tian Zhao going far away. I thought it was a dream, but there's probably the effects of the dragon's blood. Its full potential is still an enigma. See, Zen and I are going to meet the dragon priest. We would tell them what happened and make sure no one will harm you and your mother ever again. In the meantime, it's best for the two of you to avoid the city until it quiets down. I'm sorry. What are you apologizing for? When it comes down to it, we all have responsibilities for what happened. There are many things we could have done, but we did not. We have underestimated the depth of his feelings for you. But if only he didn't meet me, Xian, you can grieve for your loss. However, the time you spent together with him is not something for you to be ashamed of. He was willing to throw away everything for those memories. Hold your head high. You meant that much to him. Thank you. Or feel free to visit us if you want. We can have another round of Wei-Kuei. Huh? But Father said it is fine. So come visit us, Xian. Yes. Many years have passed since then. The girl and her mother started to move to a more rural place. She also meets her two closest friends from time to time. It's difficult after all that happened, but they are working hard to mend their relationship. I see. So are we allowed to be friends with dragons now? No. Unfortunately, this incident doesn't change the law. There are even those who think it reinforces their belief that dragons and humans should never be together. That's terrible. I agree. It's a beautiful story, but I don't like how it ends. Why? Nothing has changed. It feels like a pointless sacrifice. If you think that way, then it's not pointless. It's only pointless if you believe so. That's why I'm not going to cry over my loss. The memories we have together, they aren't meaningless. I'll continue to the past, to the future generation. It won't ever be forgotten. Huh? Don't tell me you. Goodbye. That's right. The story about us, it won't be forgotten. As long as I'm living, I'll continue to tell the world about it. No matter how the future generation perceives it, whether it's right or wrong, good or bad, only time will tell. I didn't know the mountain was so blue. There's one thing I never told anyone. Ever since that day, I no longer had total color blindness. The power of dragon essence is truly something else. You look like you have so many things pent up inside. Over here, you can shout your frustration out as much as you want. What? Don't worry, no one here beside you and I. Tian Zhao, you're an idiot. I feel better now. Really, you're such an idiot, but I'll never forget you. The end. Okay, well, I'm sad. I really am. I wanted us to have a happy ending together. Well, that's it for this series. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like it, well, you just didn't like it. I'll see you in the next series. Bye-bye.